Okay, you are getting errors in stock charts. That is absolutely no worry, Mr. Akshat. There is not an error. मैं आपको बताऊंगा वो जो आपको कुछ साइंस दिखाई दे रही है उसको रिमूव कैसे करना है. डोंट वरी. ओके, सो लेट्स मूव टू द डेटा फाइल व्हिच आई हैव सेंट टू ऑल ऑफ यू. शेयरिंग माय स्क्रीन विथ यू एवरीवन. प्लीज ओपन द फाइल. यस यस, देयर इज अ हैशटैग शाइन कमिंग अक्रॉस. नो, दैट्स नॉट एन एरर. इट इज जस्ट बिकॉज द डेटा इज नॉट फिटिंग इन टू दोज सेल्स. नो नीड टू वरी फॉर दैट. ओके, सो देयर मस्ट बी अ टास्क फाइल which is named on this date, 1st of October 2020. And this is going to be the methodology for us for rest of these sessions. As I've already stated to all of you here in the Excel, I'm not going to adopt, you know, a teaching pattern where I will first theoretically explain you that what is that function and how to use it. And no, it's because anyway, you have gone through with the basics of Excel. So I can expect that at least very some basic knowledge of you or the Excel you already have. What is my teaching pattern would be, we would go through task by task. Let's try to understand that what is the requirement of the task. Try to identify that what is the solution we can offer for this task. And by what function of Excel we may offer the solution for this task. So here in this case, our entire teaching pattern would be starting from the last step, and then it will go to the first step, and then I will explain you that what is that function and how to use it. Okay, so if you are able to identify some alternatives for solving this task, that is absolutely perfect and fine. No need to worry for that. Let me use my magnifier to see the task. Everyone, please go through the data worksheet which is named as a task file in that particular Excel file, and you will be able to see various tasks which I have given to all of you here. In various different worksheets, we are going to apply those tasks one by one, starting from the very baby steps. Chote chote task ke shuru karna, fir aage aage jate jate hum bada wala charts apply karenge, advanced level ke charts bhi karenge. Okay, so the first task we have here is prepare a bar chart of total marks in exercise 1. Okay, so exercise 1 is a one worksheet which is there in this Excel file. Everyone, please go to that worksheet, exercise 1. And we have very simple task over here is that we want the total of all the marks of students. So total marks as well as student's name. Those two information we have, we want in the chart. Now, way number one is you may select the data first. And even if you do not select the data, and if you directly go to the chart and then from there, if you want to select the data, then also it is fine. But that would be a bit complicated because over there, you know, you will have to select the range of the various data and then you will have to apply the charts. And rather than going with that way, let's select the data first. Okay, so what I need, I want student's name as well as their marks. Now, while selection, two things we'll have to take into consideration. One is, if you select only the relevant data, that is name and total, then also it's fine. But if you'll select the entire data, no, then you will have to again remove the, you know, the data which is not required in the chart, because then it will give you language 1, language 2, language 3 and all those marks. We just want total and the name. Now some smart kiddas would be like, they would be pasting the names over there somewhere, and along with that names they will paste the totals. But we can have a selective selection as well. So how can we have a selective selection which is relevant one? Okay, so let me select it from Mr. Chandan Rao to Mr. Kapil Khanna till this one. Now what you will do, everyone, start doing it along with me. Keep pressing control. Press the control key along with that. Go to the right hand side. I haven't taken my hand out of that control key yet. I'm still there in the control key. Control key is pressed. Now again with the mouse, I am selecting 531 and 456. Now I may leave the control key. So we have done a selected selection of the data. I hope you are getting. So this is how the selection should be looking like. And even if you are not able to do it, there is absolutely no worry. You may remove the unwanted data later on. Okay, so I'm going to the insert tab. And insert tab, there are various
tabs. Sir.
Yes, please, beta, bataiye.
Can you please repeat what you just did using the control key?
No worries, surely. So what I've done, I am not there on the control key right now. Step number one, I am selecting from Mr. Chandan to Mr. Kapil. So once that selection is done, then I am pressing the control key. I will keep on pressing the control key. I am not leaving it now. I am again selecting this 531 to 456 from a mouse key. And now I may leave the control key. So my data is selected, which is required for this chart. Are you getting it? The one who asked me the question?
Yes, sir. Got it.
Thank you. Bachche pooch ke nikal jate hai idhar se. Then I'm going to the insert tab. Then bar chart. You may apply any bar chart which you feel that will be, or a columnar chart which is appropriate for you, right? So I'm selecting the first one just for a basic understanding right now. And I have the axis field as well as the legion fields. Now these are the names often called as the legion fields, and this, you know, marks are written are called as the axis fields, or we may call it axis value too. Now if you haven't done it, and if you select the entire range of the data, again you may insert the chart, but at that time you will be having the unwanted data too. So we may remove the unwanted data later on. How? Let's see that. I'm deleting this chart. How can I delete the chart? You may note it down in your book. You'll have to just click on the chart anywhere randomly. And once those dots are visible to you, that means the chart is selected. Press the delete button. Simple. Delete button from your keyboard. People would be like, sir, it's key, not button. Okay, chalo, delete key bus. Okay, so let me select it from this name to total now. There would be many unwanted data as well in the chart in this case. Let's see that what is there. We have insert tab. In the insert tab, chart section, selecting the first one for the better understanding. You may select this one as well, which will give you the bars in which, you know, the total portions of every marks will be highlighted. Selecting the first one, so each and every subject will be having a different bar there. Okay, but this is not the chart we want. We do not want this language one and language two and all those numbers. So what can we do over here is, fellas and fellies, we may go to the chart. On this chart, you may have a right click. Say in between, anywhere, please click it. Once you do the right click, you will be having an option of select data from here. And in select data, there are various series which I mentioned, right? Okay, so what are the series which I require first? I may remove the unwanted series. I just want the total, nothing else, right? So what I will do, I will remove the series 1, series 2, 3.
Excuse me, sir.
Bataiye, beta, bataiye.
Sir, when we select the heading of table, that means we, while selecting the data range, when we include that name, first language, second language, And sir, instead of series, it is showing that.
Yes, why not? We can do it. We will come to that formatting. We can do it. You can select the data and that names will also be appeared over there. We can do it. I'm coming to that, right? Okay. So,
sir, it's okay now or it is not acceptable?
Fine, fine. I mean, that depends on your requirement. No, but I mean, what you want from that chart, whether you want the series to be written plainly or you want those subjects to be written. And if you want those subjects to be written, then you may format it accordingly. And I'll tell you how to format those series.
Okay, sir.
That depends on the requirement of yours. Okay. So I'm removing series 5, series 6, and only series which I'll have now will be the total, I guess. Let me press okay. But it is not happening. Yes, happening. Only total marks I have. What did I do? Step by step. Number one, you may go to any chart, right click over there, select data, and remove all the series of marks which are unwanted, not required. The names which you have, no, which are labels, which are already there at the right hand side, which you have, you do not want to remove that. If you are of the opinion that I just want Chandan, Ankita and Bhavna score, then please untick rest of them. It's a self-explanatory box. If you just want Ankita and Chandan, select it accordingly. And if you do not want to include, say, Ankita, unselect Ankita and press OK and Ankita's marks will be gone. That is a self-explanatory one. Okay. Now here I have the series. If I would have selected the topics as well, no, as Mr. Manish has rightly stated just a few minutes back, then the names of those subjects would have been given to me here. But my selection was not from the subjects and names of those, you know, language one, language two, not. My subjects were, my selection was from 1003. So that means I had not taken those subjects while selecting the data. If you would have taken it, that would have been perfectly fine. Instead of series, the names of the subjects would have been visible to you, right? Is it clear? And on the chart face as well, if you want to keep those names visible, you may keep it. If you do not want to, you may remove it. I'll come to that formatting later on. Pressing OK and you will be having only total marks there. So from the select data, you may select the relevant data as per your needs. Whatever you want to remove, please remove it. Whatever you want to keep over there, please keep it over there. That is entirely up to you. Now what happens is that, you know, a bit of the outlook will be different if you will be using some other versions actually. In 2007, I guess, this tick marks will not be there. You will have to select manually each series and remove it from here. So this tick marks and untick and tick will not be there in 2007, and I guess in 11 too it won't be there. But I have the latest version, so that's why it's visible to me. In case if you do not have it, no, then what you can do, you can select the series and from here you may remove it. Simple. Clear? Okay. We will go task by task. हमें अभी उस चार्ट के अंदर और कुछ करना ही नहीं है. अपना टास्क अकम्प्लिश हो गया, बस खत्म. अब आगे बढ़ते हैं. चार्ट का टाइटल का कुछ नाम देना है तो उसके ऊपर क्लिक करके डबल क्लिक कर सकते हो. चार्ट का नाम दे सकते हो टोटल मार्क्स ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स. वेरी बेसिक थिंग. हम अभी भी छप छपिया ही कर रहे हैं. हाँ बेटा बताइए.
सर वी कैन इवन choose the chart filter system for this.
Chart filter system?
Yes, this one.
Which one?
There is a three symbol that. No, in the chart, in the chart only. In the right hand side, there is three. The bottom. No. Yes, this one.
Yes, here. True, very true. Absolutely correct. You may use this
one
as well.
We can use this also, no, sir.
Absolutely fine. Yes, you may use this one as well. But this filter might not be there in some earlier versions. If it is not there, then you will have to do something else. That select data will be there in everyone's. Filter you may use as per your need. That's perfectly fine. Coming to that, after some time, let's move to task by task. Now, first we have done, let's go to the task number 2, what we have over there. Total marks we wanted. Now, what can we do? We may, the chart that we have prepared in exercise 1, no? We may do control X and put it at anywhere where we want to. Once you select this chart, no, just click on the chart anywhere. Once those dots will be visible to you, you may have a control X so that chart is cut. And say if you want to paste it over here, control V. Or you may just drag it downside as well. What I'm trying to convey here is that you may control V and control C chart too. If you do not want to drag it, you may move to some other worksheets as well, as per your needs. If you do this control X, no, and I want this chart to be there on some other worksheets, say on the task file, I want to keep that chart. I'll be pressing control V over here and I'll adjust the position of the chart accordingly. So that depends on your requirement, where you want this chart to be. Okay. Now prepare a combined chart of total marks and percentage in exercise 1. I hope you have got my task. You have the task file as well along with you. Okay, so what we require, total marks as well as the percentage, both shall be there in different axes on the chart. Now for that, I need to first find the percentages, right? So let's find the percentage here. I'm using the formula equal to 531 divided by, now 531 I'm not inserting manually because I want that cell to be changed whenever I copy and paste the data downside. But 600 is something which I want to remain constant, which I want to keep constant in all the formulas which I'm going to apply. So pressing enter. Now you will have to just copy and paste it to cells where you want the percentages. So I'm doing control V there. And to understand in a better manner, I may select the data and I can apply the decimals from here, that is from insert, sorry, home tab. Apply the sign of percentage. And if you want to increase the decimals from here, you may increase it. Okay, once the percentages are found, just give me a confirmation so I'll be moving ahead step by step.
Completed, sir.
Good, thank you. Now, see, here I need to do a bit of a makeup as well, right? Because agar sister makeup karke ja rahi hai aur hum nahi karke ja rahe to fir thodi si takleef hogi. Dono ka same makeup hona chahiye. To hum hai na isko select karke yahan pe bhi border apply kar dete hain. Border apply करने के लिए I am going with the shortcut key, which I had given to you. That every shortcut key in Excel can be derived after pressing Alt button, Alter button, Alt button, whatever the pronunciation you do. So I am doing Alt button. This is one by one. It is not something which I am doing at the same time. After pressing the Alt, I am taking the rest. सो जाना है. मतलब इतना भी नहीं सोना है कि भूल ही जाए कहाँ पे है. Now होम टैब में जाने के लिए आई विल बी प्रेसिंग एच, बॉर्डर्स में जाने के लिए आई विल बी प्रेसिंग बी, एंड ऑल बॉर्डर्स में जाने के लिए आई विल बी प्रेसिंग ए. सो ऑल्ट एच बी ए, बॉर्डर्स आर अप्लाइड. नाउ पीपल वुड बी लाइक सर इससे अच्छा है तो वहां पे जाके क्लिक कर लेते हैं. पर बेटा अगर ये आपको मेमोराइज हो जाएगा ना जिस दिन, फिर आपको मजा आएगा काम करने में. Once you will memorize this, ना, फिर Alt HB एकदम तुरंत फटाक से हो जाएगा. आपको वहां पे देखने की भी जरूरत नहीं पड़ेगी कि क्या है उधर, कैसे करना है. सो Alt वाली की से थोड़ी सी प्रैक्टिस करते रहिए. एंड दैट इज मोर अबाउट द प्रैक्टिस, इट कैन नॉट बी रिमेम्बर्ड. सो Alt HB, Alt HB, whenever you want to apply this borders or any shortcut you want to do or any function you want to utilize on any sort of a data, that is my request to use the Alt button. And keep deriving the shortcuts so that you get the practice of it. More the practice, better you will be. Practice makes men perfect. Some girls would be like, sir, we are feminist. Aapne sirf men kyun bola? The practice makes person perfect, right? Okay. So we have here percentages as well as the totals. Now I need the two axes, total and percentages and names. How can I do it? And if this, the problem with this is that if I'll be taking total and percentages in a simple bar chart, one will be too low and another will be too high, because these percentages are in decimals. If I'll simply just try to apply a bar chart over here, no, let's see that. Don't do it. I'm just telling it to you. Insert tab. Then in insert, if I select the bar chart here, so see, ek ka to kahin pe existence hi nahi dikhai de raha. Kidhar hai malum hi nahi. सिर्फ दूसरा दिखाई दे रहा है, क्योंकि परसेंटेज तो 1 से भी नीचे होते हैं. तो ये जो स्केल यूज कर रहा है 0 to 100, 100 to 20, 200, 200 to 300, ये जो स्केल्स यूज कर रहा है उसमें एक का तो कोई एग्जिस्टेंस ही नहीं है. तो अब मुझे परसेंटेज भी एक दूसरे एक्सिस में चाहिए, तो क्या करूं? तो इसके लिए हमारे पास है एक कंबाइंड चार्ट. क्या चार्ट है? कंबाइंड चार्ट. वो दो एक्सिस को साइमल्टेनियसली ले सकता है, दो स्केल को साइमल्टेनियसली यूज कर सकता है. वन इज द स्केल ऑफ परसेंटेज, अनदर वन इज द स्केल ऑफ नंबर्स. हाउ वी कैन डू इट, लेट्स सी दैट. ओके, आई एम डिलीटिंग दिस. नाउ सिलेक्ट ओनली द रिलेवेंट डेटा. आई नीड द नेम्स ऑफ दोज पीपल एज वेल, सो आई एम सिलेक्टिंग from Mr. Chandan Rao to Kapil Khanna. Step number one. अब मैं control key press करूंगा. कुछ कुछ लोग क्या करेंगे, पहले से कर देंगे. बेटा पहले से नहीं, ध्यान रखो, मैंने अभी तक control key press किया ही नहीं है. I am there right now in C4. I have selected up to this. Now I am pressing the control key and going to the total. Then again, starting from the percentage, I haven't put the control key down yet. It is pressed. Starting from the percentage to the last one. So that is my selective selection. It is not the blanket selection. It is a selective selection. Okay. Now I may move to insert tab, and everyone should be able to find the combo chart over here if the version is 2019 or 2016. Usse pehle wale version mein, I am really sorry, this combo chart is not available. Why should I be sorry for that? It's Excel's problem, but still I would say sorry on behalf of the Excel, because I am teaching it to you right now. If you have it in 2016 and 19 version, then you may use it. Okay, some people then would be asking me, then what is the alternative there in the older version? Uske upar baad mein aate hain. Okay, so select the second one over here. So what we have taken is, you may see the description of the chart as well on that. The description is like, use this chart type to highlight different types of information. Yes, we have two different types of information. One is percentage, another one is the total. Use it when the range of values in chart varies widely. Yes, the range of the values in the chart is because percentages are percentages and totals are totals. ये बड़े बड़े टोटल्स के सामने ये छोटे छोटे परसेंटेज कैसे लगेंगे? तो हमने दूसरा वाला सिलेक्ट किया. यू विल बी हैविंग एंड जस्ट अ सेकंड एंड यू विल बी हैविंग दिस चार्ट, सॉर्ट ऑफ अ चार्ट वेयर दिस लाइन इज टेलिंग यू द परसेंटेजेस एज वेल, दैट इज ऑन द राइट हैंड साइड. सो वी हैव टेकन द टू एक्सिस. वन एक्सिस is using the scales of marks, and another axis is using the scales of this percentage. So two things we have taken together in a single chart. two sort of scales we are using in a single chart. One is marks, another one is percentage. Yes, someone was asking me a question.
Sir, फिर से repeat करेंगे क्योंकि आपकी आवाज बीच में कट हो रही थी.
अच्छा, मेरी आवाज कट हो रही थी. ओके,
यस सर.
चलो भाई ये डिलीट कर देते हैं, पहले से शुरू करते हैं. हमें कुछ आता ही नहीं है, पहले से शुरू करते हैं. Now starting from the numbers, names to the last one. I haven't selected any key yet. Sorry, I haven't pressed any key yet. What I have done is just I have selected the names. Now I am pressing the control key. I am going to right hand side. On right hand side, control key is still pressed. Control key is used to do the selective selection of the data. Okay. From 531 to the last one, that is 456, and I am also selecting the numbers as well, from 88.50% to the 76%. Once the selection is done, then I can move to the insert tab, and in that insert tab there shall be this combined charts, and in combined chart the second cluster column chart is more suitable, and as per your requirement you may create certain other combined charts as well. We are going to that, we are coming to that. I think that would be taking a one more lecture. So let me just select whatever is there on the second chart. You may give the name of the second chart based on your requirement, whatever the name you want to. Please do control S to save it. और इसको थोड़ा सा अच्छी जगह पे बता दीजिए कहाँ पे जाना है. उनको बता दीजिए कि भाई साहब आपको नीचे जाना है. बताना पड़ता है ना, मालूम नहीं होता उनको कहाँ पे जाना है, कहाँ पे जाके सोना है, सब कुछ बताना पड़ता है. इनको बताना पड़ता है इधर सो जाओ आप, बस अब हमें अब आपकी जरूरत नहीं है. तो हमारा सेकेंड टास्क यहाँ पे कंप्लीट होता है. फॉर्मेटिंग के अंदर, सिलेक्शन के अंदर, अपने हिसाब से कस्टम डॉट चार्ट्स कैसे बनाना, सब के अंदर स्टेप बाय स्टेप हड़ू हड़ू आ रहे हैं. कोई हमें उतावल नहीं है, धीरे धीरे धीरे. ओके, लेट्स गो टू द टास्क फाइल नंबर 3 नाउ. पहले छोटे छोटे टास्क करने के, फिर बड़े बड़े में जाने का.
प्रिपेयर.
यस सर.
सर, व्हाट इज द सब दिस थिंग, I mean the ones who are not having that type of chart.
Yes, the alternative. Yes. Alternative can be there, but let me not go to the alternative as of now. I'll be surely sharing that with you. I'll use some others Excel file somewhere on some day, on some fine day, on next lecture itself only, if possible from my side, because I have few tasks to complete today. And so if for a lecture, if you can give me just an exemption for that, because again it will be taking some time, that's why it will be taking 5 to 10 minutes. I'll surely give that to you, no need to worry, but it is bit long process, that's why.
Okay sir.
Now prepare a pie chart for daily sales in Rajkot region. Ab Rajkot region hai तो पहले तो मालूम ही नहीं ये कौन से डेटा के ऊपर बात कर रहा है. सर, इतना आप इनकम्प्लीट इन्फॉर्मेशन कैसे दे सकते हो? आपको पूरा बताना चाहिए कौन से वाले वर्कशीट में जाके करना है, क्या करना है. तो मेरे बच्चे स्मार्ट है, वो समझ जाएंगे. प्रिपेयर अ पाई चार्ट फॉर डेली सेल्स इन राजकोट रीजन. सो वी हैव वन वर्कशीट दैट इज फॉर पाई चार्ट. नाउ देयर आर वेरियस ब्रांड्स ऑफ शॉप्स वी हैव हियर. नो, शॉप्स का स्पेलिंग ही गलत लिखा है. ओ माय गॉड, it's soap. This is the spelling, right? Okay. Now, number of units sold on daily basis for various brands of this, starting from Lux to others. Now, what we are supposed to find, we just want to know that what is the percentage share in the total sales we have for all this number of, you know, brands. Lux is contributing 55,000 of units. Joe is contributing around 11,000. Vivel is contributing around 8,000. Etol 18. Now the pie chart will be applicable. I know you people are aware about it, but just for a basic information again, I'm sorry, don't worry, it's not corona. And even if it is corona, it cannot be transmitted through this, right? Now, pie chart will be applicable wherever, whenever you want to give some percentage share. The percentage share will be applicable where you want to, you know, find a market share percentage of any product, or, you know, number of votes those political parties have received from the election, in the election. So wherever you want to see the percentage of share in any of the data, at that time pie chart is more suitable to represent your data, right? So what do we do in that case? Again, we may select the data first. You may go to the insert tab, and in insert, select the pie chart. This outlook will be a little bit different. I mean, the kind of a structure which you are able to see over here will be a little different in earlier versions. I'm selecting the pie chart. Ab ye 3D bhi ho sakta hai, bahut sare aur bhi ho sakte hai. Pehla wala simple lete hai. And now in simple pie chart, the pies are visible to me. But problem is that I need the percentage share as well. So how can I add the percentage share? That is the next question. Some of the things which are highly relevant to you as of now, I'm sharing with you. You may go to the center of the chart, click on the center of the chart. And once you click on the center of the chart with left key, I think the data would have been selected. The entire chart would have been selected, right? Now you may press over there only right click. And in right click, you have the option of add data labels. Data callouts are also there, which is again there in this version only. In earlier versions, it will not be. The problem while teaching the advanced Excel is that, you know, version to version, things and outlook are getting changed a lot. So I'm just clicking on the data labels as of now. But still, some people would be like, sir, aapne to percentage bola tha, idhar to value aa gayi. आपने तो परसेंटेज बोला था, तो परसेंटेज ही चाहिए हमें. तो ठीक है ना बेटा, मेरे ऊपर क्यों इतना हावी हो रहे हो? मैं कर रहा हूं ना परसेंटेज. फिर से जाते हैं, ये बीच में वहां पे जाके फिर राइट क्लिक करेंगे. अब वहां पे एड डेटा लेबल की जगह पे फॉर्मेट डेटा लेबल आ गया. देखो, पहले वो एड डेटा लेबल था, अब आ गया फॉर्मेट डेटा लेबल. तो मैंने जैसे ही उसके ऊपर क्लिक किया, तो मेरे राइट हैंड साइड में ऐसा एक डायलॉग बॉक्स ओपन हो जाता है. And in that, I may select the series, whatever I want to. If I want that, you know, Lux and every such sort of a brands to be written over there inside the pie chart, I may select the category name as well, or a series name too. So based on the requirement of mine, I would select, I would say, I do not want this value. See, value doesn't make much sense to me. I just want the percentage here. Percentage here are there. So you click on the percentage from here. Now this again would be a little bit different in the earlier version. You would have got the dialog box somewhere in between only. एक तो आपका एकदम right hand side पे नहीं खुला होगा, बीच में ही खुला होगा. तो वहाँ पे जाके percentage वाला apply कर सकते हो. Various options are there. I mean, you know, giving the colors and scales and various things are there, but ekdam chote chote minor cheezon mein nahi jana, kyunki I think that you will be getting the exposure when you will be doing it on your own, and that even you can do it. Usme zyada mujhe efforts nahi lena chahiye, lekin aayenge kuch formatting data labels wagera mein main aata hu baad mein. So this is how the pie chart looks like. Now percentage, I have told you how to add the percentages on the pie chart. Again, I'm doing control S to save it. ये भाई साहब है, इनका काम खत्म हो गया, साइड में जाने देते हैं. चार्ट का नाम देना हो तो दे दो, नहीं देना हो तो मत दो, आपकी मर्जी. Let's move to what is the time right now? 13:21. Just 5 minutes more, huh? I had too many tasks to do for today, and I'll not be getting the appropriate time for this. That's fine, no worries. Let's go to the next chart, which is prepare a tree map for political parties number of votes. Now again, a tree map is a kind of a chart which is there in the 2019 and 16 version. In earlier version it won't be. So again, if you have this version, then only you will be able to see that. What is this tree map? How it looks like? Let's see that. I'm going to the active. अच्छा किसका ट्री मैप करना था पॉलिटिकल पार्टी के वोट शेयर का ओके सो दैट इज देयर इन द पाई चार्ट ऑप्शन वर्कशीट नाउ फॉर 2017 इलेक्शन एंड 2013 इलेक्शन वी हैव गॉट द नंबर ऑफ वोट्स ऑफ सिक्योर्ड बाय वेरियस पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज इन द इलेक्शन एंड दिस इज यू नो रफली एन एक्चुअल डेटा व्हिच आई हैव टेकन सो प्लीज डोंट बी लिटिल पर्सनल ओवर हियर आई कैन अंडरस्टैंड योर ओपिनियंस अबाउट दिस लेकिन मेरा कुछ नहीं है जो है वो है बेटर मैं क्या करूं उसमें ओके सो हाउ द ट्री मैप लुक्स लाइक आई एम सिलेक्टिंग द डेटा ओनली द कांग्रेस एंड टॉपिक्स आई एम नॉट सिलेक्टिंग एज ऑफ नाउ बिकॉज एक्सेल फिर कंफ्यूज हो जाएगा तो हमें अभी एक्सेल को कंफ्यूज नहीं करना बाद में करते हैं कांग्रेस एंड नंबर ऑफ वोट्स ओवर हियर यू मे गो टू द इंसर्ट टैब एंड इन इंसर्ट टैब यू विल बी एबल टू सी दिस चार्ट वेयर द बॉक्सेस आर देयर यू नो एंड इन वन बॉक्स व्हाट पोर्शन इज फिल्ड बाय which particular box will be given to you. So if I select the first one, no, the chart would be visible like this. Now, what does it tell? It is again giving you a similar type of an output just as the pie chart, but little bit presentation and graphical way of looking is different. Now, as compared to BJP's vote share, how Congress vote share is looking like, what others is looking like, and what AAP is looking like. So rather than a round shape, we have taken a rectangular shape. And in rectangular, we have given the boxes based on the contributions which they have on the total data. In proportion to the contribution which they make into the total data, we have prepared a rectangular box. And within that rectangular box, we have allocated small boxes to each and every entries which are there. So pie chart was round, this one is rectangular, nothing else, very simple. And if you do not have this option, pie chart is again there, you may use that option for this kind of data. The interpretation of the data will be the same. The way you are looking at this presentation will be the same. Whether you use the pie chart or rectangular box and the portion in the rectangular box, both gives you a similar type of conclusions and outlook. Okay, so again, I'm doing Control S. Control S and taking it over there at the downside. थोड़ा सा नीचे जाने देते हैं चाचा जी को बता देते हैं कि नीचे चले जाइए आपकी इधर कोई जगह नहीं है And the main chart which I was supposed to do today. Let me check it whether I'll be able to do it or not. Prepare an area chart on GDP data nominal terms. Oho. 1326. Should I extend it this further? If you are of the opinion, then I should. Otherwise, I'll be signing this off. If someone can give me his or her opinion. This chart would be taking around 5 minutes. Should I?
Yes, sir.
Thank you very much. Happy to see that some people have taken the leadership, you know, I mean, in बिकॉज हम तो मैं तो आपकी जगह पे होता तो नहीं ले पाता मेरे को लगेगा कि यार बाकी सब कैसा मेरी फिर ये करा देंगे कोई बात नहीं चलो आपकी मुझे अच्छी लगी ये बात लेट्स गो टू द जीडीपी डेटा इन नॉमिनल टर्म्स सो आई एम गोइंग ओवर देयर इन द जीडीपी डेटा सो व्हाट इज देयर फर्स्ट प्लीज ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड वी हैव चाइनाज जीडीपी विच इज बिलियंस यूएसडी दैट इज यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स डॉलर्स In nominal terms, there are various ways of finding the GDP, various calculation methods to find the gross domestic product. One takes the purchasing power as well into account. I'm not going into very technical aspects of economics as of now because that would be too heavy for you to understand as right now. One is nominal terms, which try to compare the currency with the dollars and accordingly the GDP is calculated. So whatever the GDP is there of India, We have converted that into a dollar terms. We haven't taken the purchasing power parity into account in this case. Those who are not getting anything, आपको कुछ समझने की जरूरत नहीं है GDP का पहला method है nominal terms. अब ये nominal terms के हिसाब से billion dollars के अंदर हमारे पास सबकी GDP है China से China और India दोनों की हमें क्या करना है कि ये दोनों का जो टोटल है, ये दोनों के टोटल में कौन कितना कंट्रीब्यूट कर रहा है। सी पहले के जो 1991 का जो ईयर था ना, अगर दोनों के टोटल को तुम देखो तो रफली 40% वॉज द कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन बाई इंडिया एंड 60% वॉज द कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन बाई चाइना। नाउ वेयर दिस चार्ट इज यूजफुल, यू नो दैट इन टर्म्स ऑफ टोटल हाउ योर कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन इज मूविंग। If you analyze this, if you want to analyze this sort of an information, that's where the area chart is very, very useful to you. See, percentage share of GDP of India over the number of years in the total world GDP, area chart will be useful. Now I'm taking only two, that is India and China, because if I would have taken so many other countries, no, to fir yahan pe aap confuse ho jate, kyunki bahut sara data agar ikatta ho jata to fir hame interpret karna mushkil ho jata hai usme. So I've taken only India and China. And in that total, what was the contribution of India and what was the contribution of China? Here, area chart becomes very useful if the time series is too large. Say from 1991, we have the data up to 2018. I've seen one of the charts of India, percentage share of contribution of India, right from 2000. And you would be surprised to see that earlier in the world economy, India was contributing around 50% before Jesus Christ. India was contributing 50% of the world GDP. Then our share reached to around 35% in the Mughal era. At that time, we were, you know, around 30-35%. Then it was constantly decreasing. And once Britishers came into India in 1600s and 1700s, our share reduced to further extent. When Britishers came in India, we were there around 20-25% of the total world trade. And then in, you know, 1947, when the Britishers left India, we were just there to 2% of the total contribution in the entire GDP of the world. From 50% of contribution, we reached to 2% in the world. क्योंकि बाकी सब लोग बस में बैठ के चले गए और हम इधर गाड़े में थे, हम इधर लड़ रहे थे। तेरा रिलीजन अच्छा, मेरा रिलीजन अच्छा, तेरी कास्ट अच्छी, मेरी कास्ट अच्छी। ओके, लेट्स नॉट गो इनटू दैट। आई वांट द एरिया चार्ट ऑफ द कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ इंडिया एंड चाइना इन द टोटल ऑफ दिस टू। सो व्हाट आई एम डूइंग, आई एम सिलेक्टिंग इट द डेटा from this two. I haven't selected anything else yet. No, even the years I am not taking, because if I'll be putting the years, no, then too many years will be visible in the chart and the data would be looking, and chart would be little looking like a messy. So I'm just putting this, or you may select the topic as well if you want to. That's fine. You may select India, China and these figures. Now everyone should have the chart over there. I am going to the home tab, sorry, insert tab, and insert tab area chart is not visible to you, sir. How can you do that? Acha, baki sab logon mein area chart shayad ho sakta hai, shayad na bhi ho. To na ho to koi tension lene ki zarurat nahi hai. Har jagah pe ek dekho, more column charts karke ek option aata hi. Column charts mein jao, kisi aur charts mein jao, more karke ek option aata hi. To more wala jo option aata hai na, uske upar click karo. तो आपके पास सभी टाइप्स के चार्ट्स आ जाएंगे। स्टॉक चार्ट्स है, रडार चार्ट है, सरफेस या कुछ कुछ चार्ट्स ऐसे हैं जो इंजीनियरिंग में ज्यादा यूज होते हैं। सो आई एम सिलेक्टिंग द एरिया चार्ट फ्रॉम हियर एंड सिलेक्टिंग द फर्स्ट वन एंड देन आई एम प्रेसिंग ओके। नाउ सी आवर कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन इन द टोटल वॉज नॉट स्टिल, इंस्टेड ऑफ मूविंग अप we are moving down in terms of, you know, यहां से मालूम पड़ता है हमें कि हम आगे बढ़े हैं, उसमें मना नहीं। अगर मैं सिर्फ इंडिया के डेटा को कंपेयर करता तो कुछ लोग मुझे बताते, सर हम भी तो आगे बढ़े हैं, हम भी तो आगे बढ़े हैं। लेकिन बेटा ये है, वो रिलेटिव कंपैरिजन में देखना होता है कि हम आगे बढ़े वो सही बात है, राजीव गांधी कंप्यूटर लाए वो सही बात है, लेकिन बाकी सबने कंप्यूटर के साथ साथ कितना और कुछ कर लिया। तो ये भाई साहब इतना आगे बढ़ गए, हमारा कंट्रीब्यूशन अभी भी कितना इन टर्म्स ऑफ परसेंटेज, इफ यू सी दिस इज आवर कंट्रीब्यूशन इन टोटल ऑफ इंडिया एंड चाइना। सो दिस वन इज इंडिया एंड द ब्लू वन इज चाइना। सो एरिया चार्ट इज यूजफुल टू यू व्हेन यू हैव द टाइम सीरीज you know, too many number of years, too many number of periods. And you want to see that what is the percentage contribution done by one factor into the total data. In this, the total data is the GDP of India and China, gross domestic product. So what is the contribution made by China and what is the contribution made by India in the total of these two over this number of years? Area chart is one of the most applicable for this. Yes, there are a few other charts as well which can be useful over here. But in this particular situation, this chart is more useful. Right? Ab next lecture mein jo hum dekhne wale hai na, wo hum stock charts ke upar zyada focus karenge. और स्टॉक्स चार्ट्स के बाद वाटर फ्लो चार्ट है, दिस इज दैट इज आल्सो वेरी एडवांस लेवल चार्ट. एंड उसके बाद में हम चार्ट की अंदर की डिटेल्स को, स्केल्स वगैरह को कैसे चेंज करें. देखो यहाँ पे उसने स्केल कौन सा लिया है, 2000 टू 4000. अब यहाँ पे आपको 2000 से लेके 3000 का ही स्केल यूज करना हो तो कैसे कर सकते हैं. ये जो फील्ड है वहां पे नाम कुछ रखने हो तो कैसे रख सकते हैं. तो ये सब चीजें उसके बाद में आएगी वंस वी नो दैट हाउ टू अप्लाई द वेरियस चार्ट्स. राइट, ओके. So that's it from my side for this day. Thank you very much. If you have any queries related to the things we have done till now, you may ask it to me. Excel to darya hai, iske andar to bahut sari queries aayegi. Usme main mana nahi kar raha hu. Isme koi log fir mujhe puchhenge ki sir idhar percentage bhi chahiye to kaise chahiye. Matlab bahut sari queries aa sakti hain. Lekin Excel aisi cheez hai kyunki aapko andar se thoda thoda karte rehna hai aur karte 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 kuch try and error basis pe hum seekh jate hain. Excel is not something which can be taught entirely to the entire crowd, you know, because every options of every chart and everything, if we'll try to explain this, no, it would be taking many, many, many number of lectures. So sometimes we'll have to explore on our own. Okay, just give, share, let me share the attendance of yours with you. And other charts which are there in the task file, no, you may start doing it on your own. If you are unable to do it, that's perfectly fine. I'm going to do it in the next lecture. And for the next lecture, again, we'll be having a different task file. But you may start doing it for your reference. Thank you. Don't leave the class. I am